Hi, everybody. I'm Ramiro Calderon. I'm a PM here in the Microsoft Security team. I'm pretty excited to talk about the Identity Pillar module of our Zero Trust workshop. If you want to learn more about the overall ZT workshop framework and model, check the link from my friend David's video in the description. This video, just to be clear, is for those of you who are looking to deliver this workshop for your customers. So let's get right into it. Let's talk about your role delivering the workshop. While the workshop content helps with the structure, the most value that customers are going to get out of the workshop is you, is the insights that you provide along the way. When we deliver the workshop, we wear multiple hats. The first one is as a subject matter expert in the technology. You need to be very proficient in Microsoft Entra, since the bulk of activities that we're going to talk about are about deploying Entra features, right? Not everybody attending will be at the same level, so you may need to educate attendees as you go, so you need to be prepared to talk about that topic at length. The second hat that we need to wear is your experience on the identity space and the enterprise in general, beyond the products, mainly around running an IAM program and what does it mean for the customer to translate to zero trust principles. And lastly, we also need to play a role of facilitators. My experience delivering these workshops over the years is that this brings a lot of valuable conversations between the customers themselves and some light bulb moments about like doing things differently or something they thought they did that they didn't and that kind of thing. So for this workshop to be effective, we need participation from multiple teams, as some of the areas require coordination and collaboration with the identity team to implement the recommendations. So that is the nature of Zero Trust. For example, the endpoint team needs to work very closely with identity folks to enforce that the device controls are in place as part of granting access to applications and resources. Developers need to think differently about how they deliver applications to create applications that integrate with conditional access, and they are basically able to handle those modern controls. We also recommend leadership to join if it's possible, because we will cover topics that will require buy-in, support, perhaps to do things differently, inform some strategic decisions that they can make on the spot, give guidance to folks on other teams in the meeting itself, identify opportunities, and so on. So drilling a bit more into the mechanics here, we have found that a half day, kind of 4 hours, is the sweet spot as a baseline to deliver this workshop. So you can take this slide as an example. It may take longer, depending on how much the customer is engaged. You have a lot of questions or conversations with the customers, as I mentioned in the previous area, that will take a little bit longer. We designed this content to be delivered remotely or in person. If we do it remotely, we typically take 2 2-hour sessions just to keep it kind of engaged and people attention and so on. But again, this is an example. In terms of the mechanics of delivery, the workshop is essentially walking the customer through each of these boxes that you see over here, and then just ask them where they are in a particular area. So these boxes represent something the customer needs to do, make a decision, start, stop doing something, or in most cases deploy a feature, etc. If you have an existing relationship with the customer, perhaps you are a trusted advisor for years and years, or you have some previous knowledge, I recommend that you pre-populate some of the boxes based on your knowledge of the environment of the customer. Over here, we also decorated some of these boxes with the little bubbles here that represent the licensing. So that's important as we drive these discussions. And it's sometimes an interesting conversation started of, do we have that? Why do we need that? That's a good idea. Let's talk about that, the kind of discussion. So then for each box, you need to set the status based on where the customer is at, right? So you see that we organize these boxes in swim lanes. The idea here is that we put them in a logical sequence. So the order from left to right matters. That's why we put them in this first, then next approach. So this is capturing that knowledge. Another important call out here is that you will see a lot of these swim lanes concurrently, right? So this represents how many things the customer can do in parallel. So obviously it depends on the resources of the customer, how many people they can execute on their side, but this is just to show them how fast they can go. What I show here is an example of how the spreadsheet looks like after you complete the apps portion of the workshop, right? So as you can see, there's a mixture of the different states, right? So That will show you that customers may be ahead in some places and some others. But I want to talk a little bit about a couple of states that are interesting. So I put here as an example third party. This is just to capture that the customer is covering what we are telling them in terms of the topic, maybe not as optimized if we were to use Microsoft product, but especially when we report this out, we need to kind of show that the customer has some idea there. Another thing to watch for in my experience delivering this is that customers may start to talk about a wider topic when they are in, you know, before, so they get a little bit ahead. So for example, here, this is a great case where tell me about your conditional access posture. And then they basically explain that not only they have a posture, but they explain what the policies are. So my recommendation here is to keep an eye on it, you know, wear your hat as a facilitator. And then as you learn and kind of play back what you heard, that may help you to pre-populate some of these boxes ahead of time. So that helps you to keep the conversation flowing and then save some time. Couple of things here in the app section regarding the content itself is that, you know, we need to emphasize that moving applications to use Entra for authentication, single sign-on, is instrumental, fundamental step for zero trust, because this is allowing us to use conditional access, which is kind of the glue that puts everything together in terms of the controls, right? So risk signal for adaptive policies, device controls, authentication strengths, and so on. So that is very important, especially in that verify explicitly principle. Also, you will see that some of these swim lines are more around like migration, right? So they will capture migration from traditional on-prem workloads to the cloud. And again, this is for the same principle, same reason. The more you have that management plane that is modern, that allows us to implement all these zero trust principles. So let's move on to the next section and talk about users and groups. Again, very similar principles in terms of the swim lanes and the order and all that. So here, a couple of examples. You see a lot of, just an example of how things can run in parallel. You see this swim lane here to ramp up the usage of passwordless as a swim lane, while you have another separate section about provisioning all together, and they can run, it is in parallel, right? So this is important just to show, and typically, in my experience, different teams actually take ownership of those things, but it's just an example. Now, why are we emphasizing provisioning? This is just a call out here by this particular area of the workshop. An integration between the lifecycle of the user from a source of truth to drain them into Entra or creating the accounts is a fundamental element to implement that last least privilege principle and the assume compromise, right? So the idea is that an integrated provisioning pipeline based on a source of truth will help you to contain that surface of, you know, what can a user do? So it's least privilege all through and through. Well, moving on, in this section over here, we have a very, very light swim lane about devices, mainly to highlight the adoption of Entra joint devices over time. This is also a teaser for customers to go deeper, to schedule either follow-up devices workshop, if not already, or just to reemphasize the output of the previous devices workshop if you already had it. Lastly, and this is a very important area, is the SecOps friends, the operations for customers to take care of the privileged accounts, workload identities, for example, what to do with those non-human identities, as well as security operations. One thing that I want to call out in terms of the mechanics is that one of the reasons we chose Excel is it gives you that ability to take notes, right? So for example, if you need to follow up or the customer needs to follow up on, you know, we last time we did this exercise to see the configuration was a year ago and we need to kind of do it, then you can just take a note here in Excel. And especially this is important, especially if we were handed back to the customer as an output of the workshop. So that is very important for you to be just be mindful of as you go through the workshop to take advantage of these little things that provides having an Excel format. So now let's talk about the closure of the workshop. So it's a big deal. If you think about it and you step back, you literally help the customer to build a strategy And sometimes that strategy takes 2-3 years. So in some cases, based on my experience, customer literally takes that Excel spreadsheet and presents to their leadership for budget approvals or for whatever else they have internally for their planning. So we recommend to have a deliberate 1 hour meeting to go over this and then bringing the leadership on that. So what do we do in those meetings? Basically, first, we obviously share the spreadsheet back to the customer. We summarize a big picture, right? Highlighting what the customer has done so far, the progress, good things the customer is doing, especially if we have leadership there, it's important to call that out. Shout out to the team members who have made the process possible, the progress possible. And then also just the top two to five things they need to start working on based on what you found. Well, this wraps it up for this video, folks. Make sure you check the other videos in this series. And thank you for watching. See you next time.